الله، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، أما بعد، قال المؤلف رحمه الله الإمام البربهاري: والمستور من المسلمين من لا يظهر منه ريبة. So the author رحمه الله تعالى, he is speaking about المستور. المستور is the one whose condition is not known. Whose condition is not known. Like someone you see him in the masjid, he prays with us the 5 daily prayers. You don't see anything doubtful about this man. Then the origin, this man, we give him the benefit of the doubt. And we don't accuse him of anything unless we have a proof and evidence. So this is what the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, is talking about. He said, and the one whose condition is not known to us from the Muslims. But we see him, you know, he displays al-khair, he prays in the masjid, and he has good conduct and stuff like that. Then the origin, we give him the benefit of the doubt. The Shaykh, Salih bin Fawzan al-Fawzan, hafidhahullah ta'ala, he said, الأصل في المسلم العدالة. The origin when it comes to the Muslims, that he is upright, that he is not crooked, that he is upright. وَلَا تُسِيءُ الظَّنَّ بِأَخِيكَ. And you should not have doubt about your brother. You should not have bad thoughts about your brother. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن إثم ولا تجسسوا ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا. And then he said, oh you who believe, this is in Surah Al-Hujurat, oh you who believe, stay away from much of الظن, suspicion, because some of the suspicion is sinful. And do not spy on one another, and do not backbite one another. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم إياكم والظن فإن الظن أكذب الحديث. And he صلى الله عليه وسلم said, in the sound hadith, he said صلى الله عليه وسلم, be aware of suspicion, because the suspicion is the worst form of lying. Suspicion is the worst form of lying. And then he said, أي حديث النفس واستعد بالله وأحسن الظن بإخوانك المسلمين. Said, you should seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have good thoughts about your Muslim brothers. فإذا ثبت لك أن هذا المسلم عليه ملاحظة فإنك تناصحه سرا. But if it has been confirmed with you that this Muslim has some issues, then you should advise him in private. You should advise him in private. وَتَسْتُرْ عَلَيْهِ. And you cover him up. You don't expose him to the people. قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَمَنْ سَتَرَ مُسْلِمًا سَتَرَهُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever conceals a Muslim, means he conceals his sins, he conceals his fault and the like, Allah will conceal him in this dunya and also in the hereafter. So whoever basically covers him up and does not expose him to the people, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do the same thing with him in this dunya and the next. وَلَا تَفْضَحُ وَلَا تُشَهِّرْ بِهِ فِي الْمَجَالِسِ. And do not expose him when you are sitting in gathering. Don't say person so-and-so, he did this, he did that. And you expose your brother. بَلْ عَلَيْكَ أَن تُنَاصِحَهُ سِرًّا بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ مَعَ السِّتْرِ عَلَيْهِ. Rather, you should advise him in private while you conceal his faults. You conceal his fault and you don't expose him. So this is the chapter, this chapter. So we're going to go to the next chapter, inshallah, because this chapter is short. So basically, in this chapter, what we learn that the origin when it comes to the Muslim, that the Muslim is upright, unless there is an evidence that says otherwise. If there is an evidence that says otherwise, then he will not be upright. But until then, if you don't have no evidence, then you cannot accuse someone of something they did not do while you have no knowledge about. So you should always have good thoughts about your brothers. قال المؤلف رحمه الله وكل علم ادعاه العباد من علم الباطن لم يوجد في الكتاب والسنة فهو بدعة وضلالة ولا ينبغي لأحد أن يعمل به ولا يدعو إليه. The author رحمه الله تعالى, he said, and every knowledge that a person claims that he has the knowledge, or that he has the hidden knowledge, because the Sufiya and also the Shia, they claim that they have, that the Sharia, the legislation, has an apparent meaning and has a hidden meaning. Has an apparent meaning and has a hidden meaning. So now, the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, he's refuting these individuals who claim that they know the hidden meaning of the Sharia. They have the hidden knowledge of the Sharia. Then he said, if anyone who claims that he has hidden knowledge, he has the hidden knowledge of the Sharia, and that which is not found in the Quran or Sunnah, then this is an innovation and it is misguidance. وَلَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ يَعْمَلَ بِهِ, and it is not permissible for anyone to act upon that or to call to it. Sheikh Saleh bin Fawzan al-Fawzan, حفظه الله تعالى, he said, علم الباطن عند الباطنية من الإسماعيلية وغيرهم الذين يقولون إن للنصوص ظاهرا وباطنا. He said, the hidden knowledge is claimed by those Batiniyya. Batiniyya are those, the sect that claim that the Sharia has a hidden meaning. Has a hidden meaning. Only them, they know it. Like Al-Ismailiyya, the Ismailis. Ismailis, they are Shia. They are the one of the worst of the Shia. So they claim that they have the hidden knowledge. So for example, they say that the text, they have an apparent meaning and they have a hidden meaning. They have an apparent meaning and they have hidden meaning. For example, the Shia, they say, Salawat al-Khams, the five daily prayers, right? They say that the five daily prayers, they are Ali radiallahu anhu, al-Hasan wal-Husayn, Fatima and Muhsin. And this is batil, this is false. This is false. How can you say something like that? It's not in the kitab. It's not in the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-batin la ya'rifuhu illa khawasum. And that hidden meaning is known only by those who are very special in their sect. Very special people. Very few. Wa amma al-dahir, fahada inda al-amma. They said, as far as the apparent meaning, then the commoners, they know this. The commoners, the common Muslim, they know the apparent meaning. But the hidden meaning, only those few from them, from the cream of the crop, according to them. Those are the ones that know the hidden meaning of that, of the Sharia. يقولون المراد بالصلاة الدعاء. And they say what is intended by salat is dua, supplication. فَمَنْ دَعَى فَقَدْ صَلَّى. Whoever makes dua, then he has prayed. Subhanallah, ajeeb. He has prayed. لَيْسَ الْمُرَادِ الصَّلَوَاتِ الْخَمْسِ وَصَلَاتِ النَّافِلَةِ. What is intended by a salat is not the five daily prayers, nor is it the voluntary prayers. ويقولون المراد بالزكاة طهارة النفس وتنقية النفس ولسان مراد زكاة المال. And they also say and they claim that what is intended by zakat is not the zakat that you give, 2.5% that you give like every Islamic year. If your wealth reaches nisab, then you give 2.5% from your wealth. They said, no, it doesn't mean that. This means purification of the soul. So based on that, you don't give zakat. There is no financial obligation upon you. All you have to do is purify your soul. So this is what is intended by zakat to them. Zakat is not the zakat that we know. You give the zakat. No. Zakat is to purify your soul. And this is what is intended by it. وَيَقُولُونَ الْمُرَادِ بِالصِّيَامِ أَسْرَارُهُمْ وَمَدْهَبُهُمْ. And what is intended by fasting the month of Ramadan, is their secrets. The secrets of these deviant sects. Or you could say that some of them are kuffar, like al-Isma'ili, kuffar. So they say that fasting means the secrets, their secrets, and also their madhab, their madhab, their methodology. ولذلك هم يسمون بالمنظمات السرية, and that's why they are called secret societies or secret organizations, like the Masonic and the like. So these are the same. We have them in Muslim land. So we have these individuals. ويقولون الحج معناه الذهاب إلى مشايخهم وليس المراد الذهاب إلى بيت الله للحج والعمرة. And the Hajj, according to them, is not to go to travel to Mecca and perform Hajj. No. The Hajj to them is to travel to their shuyukh, their teachers and the like. This is the Hajj to them. So that's why they say the Sharia has apparent meaning as a hidden meaning. So this is the hidden meaning that they're talking about. This is وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ misguidance and كُفْرُ وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ وَقَوْلُهُ وَهُوَ بِدْعَةٌ وَضَلَالَةٌ أي القول بعلم الباطن بدعة في الدين وضلالة عن الحق. So the statement of the author رحمه الله, anyone who claims that there is a hidden meaning to the legislation, there is apparent meaning and there's a hidden meaning, then this is an innovation in the religion. It is an innovation in the religion, and also it is misguidance. والعلم لا يحصل إلا بالتعلم على العلماء الربانيين. The Sheikh said, knowledge cannot take place and it cannot be achieved unless you learn from scholars who are well-grounded in it. Scholars who are well-grounded in knowledge. Naam. And then he mentioned the statement of Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala. He said, وَالْجَهْلُ دَاءٌ قَاتِلٌ وَشِفَاؤُهُ أَمْرَانِ فِي التَّرْكِيبِ مُتَّفِقَانِ. So he said, rahimahullah ta'ala, Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim, he said, an ignorance is a deadly disease. Ignorance is a deadly disease. And its cure is two things that are in agreement with each other. نص من الكتاب أو من سنة. Is it a text from the Quran or the Sunnah? Is what? Is the cure to ignorance. طيب. وطبيب ذلك العالم الرباني. And the doctor of that means the doctor of the text is the scholar. Because the scholar is like a doctor. So he looks at the text and see which one is wajib, obligatory, which one is not wajib, which one is makruh, disliked, which one is disliked but it is forbidden, or the like, which one is highly recommended, which one is forbidden, and the like, which one is halal, which one is haram. That is the scholar. The scholar, he has that He has that ability to do that. So Allah has blessed him with knowledge, so he'll be able to find out whether this is halal or haram or the like. هذا هو العلم. He said, this is knowledge. Knowledge coming from the Kitab was Sunnah. ليس العلم بالذوق والإلهام. Knowledge should not be based upon one's desire. One's desire and also الإلهام, intuition. Intuition. And intuition, some of it can be from Allah. Some of it can be from Allah, intuition. You know what intuition means? Anybody knows what intuition is? Okay, I'll give an example. Intuition, like Abu Bakr Siddiq, radiallahu anhu, he had a very strong urge that his wife was going to have a girl, a baby girl. This is intuition from Allah. طيب. So he was overwhelmed by that feeling. And he said, you're going to have a girl. And she did have a girl. This is called ilham. Likewise, when Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu, he was delivering the khutbah in Medina. And he sent, prior to that, he sent a Muslim army. And then, while he was giving the khutbah, suddenly he said, Ya Sari al-Jabal al-Jabal. So he was calling upon the Muslim army to go to the mountain, go to the mountain, hide in the mountain. And the Muslim army, they heard him. They heard the voice of Umar al-Khattab, even though Umar, he was not there. He was in Medina. So this is ilham. This is called ilham from Allah and karamat. These are from karamat al-awliya. The supernatural things that happen to al-awliya, those close friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this can happen. But the condemned intuition, which is from the shaitan and from the person's desires, God spoke to me, like the Christians say, and stuff like that. This is batil. This is false. This is false. طيب. So, ولا علم الباطن الذي عند الباطنية. And knowledge is not the knowledge that is claimed by the secret societies and the secret organization from the deviant sect like al-Ismailiyya and other than them. Because they claim the Sharia has an apparent meaning, has a hidden meaning. So the apparent meaning is known by everyone. All the Muslims know. And the hidden meaning, only the few of them know. The few of them know that knowledge. But this is false. This is batil. إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ مَا جَاءَ عَنِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. The Sheikh said, knowledge is what came from Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. وما قاله الصحابة وما قاله صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, and what the companions of the Messenger of Allah have said. He said, هذا هو العلم. This is knowledge. وما خرج عن ذلك فهو جهل وضلال وليس علما ولا هدى. And whatever comes out of that, whatever is not included in that, then it is ignorance. And it is misguidance. And it is not considered knowledge, nor is it considered guidance. قوله ولا ينبغي لأحد أن يعمل به ولا يدعو إليه. And it is not permissible for anyone to act upon what? Upon that claimed hidden knowledge that the Sufis and those Shia claim that they know the few of them know the hidden knowledge of the Sharia. So it is not permissible to act upon that. And to call to it, بل يجب الحذر من هذا. Rather, you should be warned of that. لأنه من نزغات الصوفية وشطحات الصوفية الذين يرون أن العلم ليس في الكتاب والسنة. This is from the deviation of the Sufis. From the deviation of the Sufis, because they don't consider knowledge to be from the Quran or Sunnah. So they base their knowledge upon intuition. They base their knowledge upon dreams and the like. This is what they're upon. إنما هذا للعوام والذين لا يعرفون. So they claim that they have a connection with Allah. So they don't need the Quran or Sunnah. والعياذ بالله. And that's why they used to say to the people of the Sunnah, they used to say, أنتم تأخذون العلم عن عبد الرزاق. You take knowledge from عبد الرزاق. And we take knowledge from الخلاق, the creator. عبد الرزاق is a scholar. Scholar in Yemen. الإمام عبد الرزاق الصنعاني رحمه الله. And scholars, they used to travel to him to learn from him. He was a scholar of hadith. So they used to travel to him and take knowledge from him. So the Sufiya, they used to say, you take knowledge from Abdul Razzaq, but we take knowledge from Allah directly. This is, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ misguidance. إِنَّمَا هَذَا لِلْعَوَامُ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْرِفُونَ. So they claim that the apparent meaning of the Sharia is only for those who are commoners and those who don't know. But us, we have special knowledge. وَيُسَمُّونَ هَذَا عِلْمُ الشَّرِيعَ. So they call the apparent meaning of the Quran and Sunnah is the knowledge of the Sharia. أما العارفون بالله فهم أهل علم الحقيقة. As for those who have knowledge about Allah, they have the knowledge of the reality of that Sharia. So basically they mean by that the hidden meaning. The hidden meaning. Because they claim there is apparent meaning and there is a hidden meaning. طيب. So the apparent meaning is known to all the commoners. As far as the hidden meaning is known only to a few of them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from that. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.